A frigid morning begins with no power at thousands of homes and summit ski areas. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News. A gas line rupture cut power to 17,000 homes and local resorts this morning, touching every corner of Summit County. The first outage came around 6 a.m. with rolling blackouts through the afternoon on one of the chilliest mornings of winter. Temperatures dipped to negative 23 in Summit Cove and negative teens across the county. But take it from Tim, waiting for the River Run gondola to start spinning on generator power. It's nothing compared to the Midwest last month.
Just came back from 3 weeks in Chicago, so this actually feels warm.
Warming up at Christie Sports in the Village was a group from Kansas City. Scott says yesterday was worse than this morning.
I think yesterday was the coldest day I've ever skied. The wind was gnarly.
Keystone opened 45 minutes late with limited chairlifts. They were running off backup power, making Annie from University of Denver nervous.
I'm a little bit nervous for these ski lifts. Every time they stop, I think I'm going to be nervous if the power's back out, but I'm still excited to go out.
Braving the cold and gondola like a champ was C-Rock's Fox.
Stuck in the gondola with Phil, forcing me to come on the coldest day of the season.
Xcel Energy has restored power to most towns and resorts by 3 p.m. Summit School District canceled class at all elementary schools today due to the outages. Students at Summit High, Summit Middle, and Snowy Peak still had class. Tomorrow is the 17th year of the Beacon Bowl at A-Basin. Catherine Fuller with the ski area.
The main event is a beacon competition for everyone from ski patrollers to backcountry skiers kind of wanting to hone their skills.
Competition begins at 9:15 a.m. at the base of a Lenaway chair. There's also an avalanche dog demo at 10:30. Registration is open online or on site tomorrow morning. All proceeds benefit the Colorado Avalanche Information Center. Take it from the folks at Leadville's Cloud City Wheelers. Biking on snow is nothing like dirt.
Fat biking is, you know, it's an adventure to begin with, and with most fat bike rides, you might have to get off your bike every once in a while.
That was Wheelers director Sterling Mudge, host for tomorrow's 9th annual winter bike race at Copper. It's a night event beginning at 6:15 p.m. with 120 to 140 riders on an 11-mile course lit by headlamps.
It's very spectator-friendly because you get to see the racers a couple times, and you get to see them go down some steep hills, so it's pretty exciting for all.
WinterBike is the second in a 5-race series supporting trail stewardship in Lake County. The first, at Tennessee Pass last month, celebrated 19 years of biking on snow. It makes a difference to have those fat bike tires.
If you do show up with a regular mountain bike, more power to you. The next race you do, you'll probably show up on a fat tire bike.
Register for WinterBike at coppercolorado.com. In sports, the Nuggets play the 76ers tonight at 5 p.m. on ESPN. The Avalanche are off until tomorrow for the Islanders. In World Cup ski racing news, Austria's Ramona Siebenhofer won women's alpine combined at World Championships today. Lindsey Vonn took one run, finishing top 10. Alice Merriweather was top American in 7th after 2 runs. Tomorrow is men's downhill. Italy's Dominic Paris was fastest in training today, coming off a Super G win Wednesday. At Freestyle World Championships in Utah, Chloe Kim was unstoppable today, winning women's snowboard halfpipe. American Maddie Mastro took 3rd. For men, Australia's Scotty James won with a 97.5. American Toby Miller finished just off the podium. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the WIS agency, captains Abby Lau and Katarina Lee of the Tigers swim team admit they weren't excited for their senior year. Lau explains.
We went into the season kind of both feeling a little burnt out, I think, and then we just fell back in love with the sport.
But the girls got back in the pool and started breaking school records, one after the other.
This team, I've kind of grown with them, and they've kind of been my family over the past 4 years, so it's really exciting that we've gotten the chance to go to states for the past 3 years.
Lau and Lee are responsible for more than 5 school records now. They joined 5 other swimmers at the state championships in Fort Collins this weekend. That's the largest summit contingent in years, and they're ready to prove they belong. Lee.
As the years have gone by, I think we've improved a lot, and we have a chance to maybe make it to finals. If we can do that again or even do better, I think that would be really, really fantastic.
Racing opens today and continues tomorrow. Stay tuned for results. Later today, Tigers hockey plays Chaparral in Denver, and tomorrow, boys and girls basketball face Eagle Valley at home. Tigers Nordic ski team has a skate race in Steamboat. And Breckenridge Vipers hockey is back tomorrow for a grudge match against the Vail Yeti at home. Puck drop is 8 p.m. at Stephen C. West Ice Arena. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News.